Hey guys, we are headed out today to do two jobs. The first job is going to be a tile clean and seal, and also a carpet cleaning. And I think the second job later in the afternoon is going to be just carpet cleaning, I believe. So we're headed up to Georgetown right now. So I will check in a little bit later as soon as I get out there. It's about a 20-minute drive, so we'll be checking in shortly. Hey YouTubers, we're out at the job where I'm going to do some carpet and some tile. In the garage now. We're going to go in there and take a look around. It's going to be tile cleaning and tile sealing and carpet cleaning. So basically, everywhere in the house has got floor. It's a move-in. It's pretty cool. It's my attorney that I've used several times when I was doing a little child custody thing when I got my daughter. So good working relationship. Let's take a look at the tile first here. It is not in just terrible shape. This is, I think the house was built in 2000. This is the entryway from the front door, which nobody really used, didn't look like. Bathroom is gonna appreciate me a little bit here. This is the dirtiest I think I've seen. Kitchen has got some dirty grout right through here where the stove is at, and usually in front of the sink really catches hell too a lot of the times. So we should expect to see this. We'll have to remember this correlation. We're at the stove, pan down. So I'm gonna say this is the dirtiest grout line there is. So what will we compare this to? Maybe this over here, because this is not nearly as dirty as here. So we're gonna make this match that one over there, where it's not dirty. All right, coming through here, fairly dirty here. Make your way from the garage and around this side, front of the dishwasher and the sink. So that's fairly dirty. And over here, not so much. Now we'll go take a look at the carpet. It's a really nice, it's a custom home. Apparently the architect that lived here was the one that designed it, but he put carpet in the bathroom, which I don't understand. Maybe that's why I put the fan up there, because he was expecting carpet not to work out in the bathroom so well. So there you go. Light. Can't find the lights in this house. Let's see here. Nothing. Fan. There we go. And look, it's got a, in 2000, that was bleeding edge to see a TV in the bathroom. All right, now, looking around the carpet some more. I'm doing the tile first. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do the tile, I'm gonna let it dry, then I'm gonna do the carpet, then I'm gonna come back and I'm gonna seal the grout. And sealing the grout is just about the least fun thing I think that I do, I believe. Because I do it, there's different ways. They make these sticks that you can stand up and do it. But I crawl around on my knees and do all the tile grout, or the grout sealing rather. Okay, there's this room here. And I think there's one more room over. No, there's a couple more. There's this one here. I don't know. All right. Through the hall we go. Light. Bathroom. here. I think there's one more room. It's a pretty good sized place. So I allotted most of the day for here. So I'm working all by myself. All right, guys, I'm gonna get started. I'm gonna get started on the tile. I brought the good tripod today, the one from the 80s, real sturdy. All right, I'm gonna get started and I will check back in shortly. Appreciate you guys watching. I just put up a video. You won't see this till tomorrow, but I just put up a video today that there was a song in it. So I got fussed at on YouTube. I don't know how you're supposed to deal with that. I don't know how you're supposed to control what plays in the background if you're inside a restaurant or a furniture store or whatever else. But anyway, I got fussed at. What's weird is I don't quite have 100 subscribers, but yet because there was a song playing in the background, that video got monetized to go toward any views that it gets. The artist gets paid. So there you go. All right. Nevertheless, it's all in good time. All right, check in a minute, guys. All right, I'm gonna let that dwell for a minute. R20. done with the tile here. I turned the fans off, so you hear me talk. In some places, I am finding grout haze, which is something I'm glad I don't find all the time, but getting some here nonetheless. Got to wait for it to completely dry. I've already hit it with a few different acids. I've hit it with a vinegar. I did the whole floor in vinegar, actually. And then I did some straight vinegar directly on. Like over here seems to be about the worst of it right here. This is the grout haze that I'm finding. Over here, I went ahead and I put the sealer on it just to see if when the sealer dries, we fix the grout haze problem, because I'm gonna seal it anyway. So I've also got this guy here. You know, this is another option here for grout haze. I've tried CLR on it, calcium lime and rust. You know, grout haze is generally a mineral deposit. It just doesn't make sense why it's a mineral deposit covered with dirt that I exposed. Grout is the one surface, the one thing that you clean that will sometimes shoot you in the foot. There's a lot of times you'll expose like your regular grout and stuff. Like say somebody replaced some tile and the color didn't match, and they replaced a handful of tiles and the color didn't match and it all got dirty, and then I come and I clean it off and I expose the different color grout that you didn't know you had that problem until you went to the trouble to clean it. Well, here it looks like in a few places I'm gonna have some grout haze. So I'm gonna turn the fans back on and I'm gonna switch over to carpet cleaning and give it time to dry out the rest of the way, and then I've got to make a decision on what it's going to take to get the grout haze off. So, you know, it's Monday, it's a beautiful day, it looks like spring, so not that big a deal. I've certainly ran into worse, but there's just not always an explanation to why you run into grout haze. Generally, when you run into mineral deposits or something like that, it's in a bathroom, you know, not in the kitchen. In the kitchen, you run into dirt and grease. In the bathroom, you run into mineral deposits, at least in Austin, because Austin is sitting on limestone, so there's hard water everywhere. All right, guys, I've just been packing around the little mini camera here. I put you guys back on the pedestal here, and then I'm going to start doing some carpet cleaning. And when I get done with the carpet, it'll be time to seal the grout or spend another couple hours trying to make it ready to seal. You never know. It's just the business, nature of the business. All right, I'll check back in shortly. All right, I've done two rooms down in the hall. I've got this room and the next room to do. I'll show those two. And there's about three or four more large rooms to go after that. And the fans are still drying the grout, so it's kind of noisy out there. over there in the corner was some dog urine. It was bleaching out with the peroxide.
All right.
Getting ready to clean the world's largest bathroom and two closet combination I think I've seen in a really long time. I don't know, less carpet, but it is what it is. Behind it, it's a bedroom here. Beyond that, there is a living dining combo, and then maybe it's a little dining room, or maybe a little office up front or whatever it is. I'm not exactly sure what. The grout is drying. I'm gonna seal it last. Sealing grout is like watching paint dry. Probably won't show much of that. A little bit, not much. The grout haze that I found, it looks like it's gonna be in just only a few areas. And what I'm gonna do with that is I'm gonna do lime away with a brush on the end of a drill. Nylon brush. That's gonna be the cure for that. And then seal right over the top of it. And that should have it. I'm not exactly sure why it's doing it. Maybe when I get down, start crawling around on the ground, I'll be able to do more. Here we go, let me clean this.
All right.
Back you guys up a little bit. Let's see what we can see here. Boy, it looks like a mile away to the mirror. All right. A little bit more in the bathroom and then the master bedroom here. And groom this. Keep cleaning. Over here is good, maybe. Wow. Hey, how you doing? Here. All right. That's probably good. Maybe. Sorry for all the messing around with camera and stuff. Whoops. All right. Until the camera crew shows up, you gotta be patient. Hey guys, we're gonna take a look at all the carpet that I cleaned. We're gonna look at the grout, and then I'm gonna turn it off and I'm gonna seal the grout. I'll show a little bit of the grout sealing, then I gotta cut it off because the grout kind of kept me coming back all day. I would clean the carpet a little bit, then come back and mess with the grout a little bit because it tried to turn white in some places, and it bothered me. I had to try to fix it. So what I did to fix it was I used the drill with a like some kind of poly type brush on it. I don't know exactly what it was. So I would spray either vinegar or lime away or both. Use both basically, and I would buzz it out of there and wipe it up. And it still maintained a little bit of a white, kind of funny looking, like hard water type finish. Not sure why. It must be something that was in the grout in a few places. But first, let's take a look at the carpet that I did. This is a living dining combo. Wasn't really anything going on here at all. This is the office, I suppose, here. Nothing much there to look at. We'll go back and take a look at the bedroom and the world's largest closet. We'll find some lights here. Right. I don't know where the lights are. I'm pretend like you can see this. I don't know where the lights are at. And in here, really nothing to do but footprint all across that, and just routine cleaning. Just the carpet treated me better than the tile and grout did. If anything's going to shoot you in the foot, it'll always be tile and grout. I've had some automotive upholstery shoot you in the foot too, but and every once in a while a couch will. Carpet treats you the best. There we go. Now this room here, maybe I can find a light. Yeah. Nothing much to see here. Turned out good. This hallway, this room. Here we go. Now we'll take a look at the grout. I wanted to make a reference this morning before I began or whatever, so we could see the difference. Still trying to dry in places. This was what was the dirtiest grout there was, and we're going to try to match that right there. And it may well be, but I've wet it and re-wet it and dried it so many times. So the grout's got a really funny pitted. I don't know if it was some of the grout might have been replaced, because this grout here is nowhere near like other. Like here's another one. It's another piece where it's kind of funky looking, like maybe somebody replaced it or something. It's not the same consistency of grout as the rest of it. That was really about it. It tried to turn white, so I said I use that. You want to use it whenever you have a white looking grout or something like that. You would have to assume it's mineral based, and you would use a light acid to reverse the mineral in it. When you're doing grout, tile and grout on the floor, it's always like a dirt or grease you're trying to break through, so you would use a high pH cleaner, maybe a solvent, and then that dissolves everything and you blast out of there and rinse it away. If it's a bathroom, you're dealing mainly with hard water stains, so we'd use something more acidic, just not so acidic that you would mess with the water faucets. All right, I'm gonna get to sealing some grout here. Let me show, in case there's anybody watching that doesn't know anything at all about grout sealing. It's so little to know. Let's go over this right here a little bit. All right, I believe we can see. There's this brush on the end of the bottle. What you do is you draw the lines here, and it can puddle up in there, and it's fine. It's not a problem at all. If you're using a good sealer,
you can't put two coats because after the first coat dries, the other one you try to put will beat up on top of it. So you can only put one and it seals out the second coat. So, you know, and grout sealing is pretty much a premium service. It's something that, you know, that you charge a little extra for, and it's not due to the complexity of it at all. It's due to the time consumption and all the fun of crawling around your knees on the hard tile while you seal it. So right now I've done, let's see, I don't know, not just a whole lot of square footage. I gotta go turn the camera off and I gotta put my knee pads on so I can hurry up and get finished with this. I did just this front area here. So I'm gonna go put some knee pads on and I gotta finish out the rest of it. And then I may check in one last time before I leave. Anyway, I gotta hurry up and finish with this. Wow, what a day. All right, I'll check in maybe one more time. Okay, all of the grout has been sealed. And I started over here. So you can see how it's soaking in. Like there where it's dry, there where it's still wet. So when you put the sealer down, it gets dark one more time. You have to wait for it to soak in and then dry. As far as my personal opinion with sealing grout, you can do it if you want or not. It doubles the price of the job because it pretty much doubles the amount of work you do. Grout will still get dirty whether it's sealed or not. I guess it would maybe prevent it from being like dyed if you spill some kind of dye in it. It would keep it from being dyed a different color. It's the right thing to do, but you don't always have to do the right thing. It's the right thing to do to wax your car too, but not everybody does that. So anyway, all right, I'm going to lock the place up. And let's do that right now. Close the garage door. All right, this job is finally done, guys. Appreciate you watching. Please subscribe. I should hit 100 subscribers. I was at 98, looking to get 100, and that's the starting point for this whole vlogging thing. All right, there's one more job to do, and it's very small. It's in an apartment, and I'm probably not going to cover it. This is probably going to be the end of it for today. but we'll be back at it again tomorrow. I appreciate you. You're watching the videos. Please subscribe, like, comment, all of that's cool. All right, see you tomorrow, guys.